Thank you for giving me a chance for the talk. I am Shoma Sugimoto, coming from Tsinghua University. My title is on the Feigen Chipnin construction. First, we explain some background and introduction. The vertex operator algebra, VOA, was introduced in 1980s as mathematical formulation of two-dimensional conformal theory. But in this talk, I don't use the definition vertex operator algebra. This is some infinite dimensional vector space with some complicated algebraic structure. And in this...
Can we put the box here? Not there?
Okay,
I see. Then we need to use the microphone. Yes, sorry.
ちょうどいい音が。大丈夫です。In this case, the vertex operator algebra decomposes the finite dimensional general Lagrange space with respect to the conformal weight. And in this situation, we can define the Q character, character QV, given by this Q series. And it is well known that by Yong Chan Zhu in 1996, for a vertex operator algebra is rational, namely in the case the semi-similar representation category is semi-simple and finite, so they are only finitely many simple modules and decomposes into the finite, all modules decomposes into the direct sum of simple modules. Then, ありがとうございます。The character the character gives the modular form. More precisely, the linear space found by all character of a simple module or all modules is closed under the modular transformation. So the rational vertex operator algebra is the algebraic version of modular form. And in other words, if the character of V is some spoiled modular form, spoiled means this is not modular form but near to modular form, in some sense, like Mock modular form or Pauli theta function or quantum modular form like this one, then V is non-rational. And recently, the study of such kind of spoiled modular form and non-rational vertex operator algebra is hot because of the relation between two-dimensional conformal field theory and more higher dimensional quantum field theory. On the other hand, recently in 2017, I think, Gukov, Patrov, Vafa introduced an invariant of Plumbed 3 manifold called homological block. This is the invariant of 3 manifold value at the Q series. And this is very interesting invariant because it gives the rich examples of such kind of spoiled modular form. So if we can compute the characters of the homological block of some simple type of Plumbed 3 manifold, then it gives the Pauli theta function, Mock theta function, and its generalizations. And recently, it is proven that the homological block is converges to the Witten-Shetkin-Zwipe invariant at the corresponding root of unity. This is proved by, finally, Yu Yamakami. He's also postdoc of Kyushu University, I think. So my problem is that we want to construct non-rational vertex operator algebra with modules whose character give the modular form, homological block. And we also want to study the representation theory of such non-rational vertex operator algebra. So we consider the following situation. So, yes, in some sense, if there exists such non-rational vertex operator algebra is a strong invariant of such kind of 3 manifold. Because it reconstructs the homological block and Witten-Shetkin-Zwipe invariant. And Plumbed 3 manifold is some non-hyperbolic 3 manifold given by the following. So we have some Plumbed graph. This is 3 graph, and each vertices has some integer weight. And for this graph, we consider the following link. Each vertice is corresponding to the trivial knot, and H means this trivial knot connecting. And by considering the dense surgery of this link, we have some non-hyperbolic 3 manifold. This is called Plumbed 3 manifold. And for this problem, I want to solve this problem. I would like to consider iterative some algorithm that computes the homological block for given parameter graph. And has the following properties. First, to apply the vertex operator algebraic context, each step has a, must have a counterpart of the vertex operator algebra side. For example, if some deformation of Q series exists in such kind of algorithm, then it must be corresponding to the some deformation of given vertex operator algebra. And second, each step reduces to the vertex operator algebra to an easier, for example, rational vertex operator algebra, more rational, near to rational vertex operator algebra, because we want to study the vertex operator algebra's theory, representation theory. So we want to reduce the difficult things to an easier thing. And third, in general, the algebraic, as we show later, the algebraic structure of non-rational vertex operator algebra is difficult and complicated. So we sometimes can use some direct computational or algebraic method to such kind of vertex operator algebra wise module. And if such a algorithm exists, the vertex operator algebra wise modules appearing in each step are different to each other. So each step or algorithm itself should be independent of the algebraic structure of such kind of vertex operator algebra. So in particular, such algorithm or step should be depend on some real algebraic or combinatorial or geometric or anyway, easier than the vertex operator algebra structure. And in this talk, I will present the Feigen-Chiprin construction. This is the main theme of this talk, as a candidate of such an expected step or algorithm. In fact, I will explain the following. First, Feigen-Chiprin construction is taking global section functor of the equivalent G-band of the flag variety with the phi bar is given by vertex operator algebra wise module with a nice B module structure. I will explain later. And second, it doesn't depend on the vertex operator algebra structure, but only on this B module structure. So we can use some real algebraic theory or geometric representation theory to study the corresponding non-rational vertex operator algebra. So it is useful. We will explain later. And third, we can study the vertex operator algebra using this strong tools in geometry, such kind of analog of Polyvivos theorem or cohomology vanishing or character formula like this one. I will explain later. And in particular, we have the character formula of this global section functor of Feigen-Chiprin construction. So by this character formula, we can reduce the computation of this Feigen-Chiprin construction to the character of the fiber. So this corresponding to the each step of algorithm in the corresponding Q-series side. And in fact, the homological block of n plus 2 leg star graph, like such kind of very fundamental class of Lambda graph, is obtained by applying the above character formulas to a theta function iteratively. And theta function coming from the character of lattice vertex operator algebra. And this is one of the most famous examples of rational vertex operator algebra. So this is easier than corresponding Feigen-Chiprin algebra. So we want to construct such kind of correspondence. And this is conjecture. And this conjecture is proven in the case L equal 1 or 2, but I want to, my dream is to prove this correspondence, but not yet. Here, this V lambda is a lattice vertex operator algebra module, whose character gives a theta function, and the character formula is given by this Feigen-Chiprin construction. And this character formula coming from some real algebraic discussion and geometric discussion, not coming from vertex operator algebra. And by using this character formula to which parameter in lambda, we can reduce the character of this nested Feigen-Chiprin construction. Nested means there are m times global section functor to m minus 1 global section functor. So by using this character formula repeatedly to the theta function, we obtain almost the n plus 2 homological block. And let us start Initial move against pre-construction. For simplicity, we consider the case G equals L2 at first. This is the essential case, I think. Let us take the P because the integer becomes 2, and let us take R from 1 to P. This is some parameter. And we consider the B module, V plus minus R. And in this, here we consider the case, the Borel subgroup is negative Borel subgroup, but we can consider the P plus version also. And we also assume that there is a linear operator from VR plus minus to V minus plus PR. Later, this is called a short screen operator. In the example of some non-rational matrix operator algebra. And we assume the following short-cut sequence of B module. Namely, the kernel of this linear operator is maximally cell to some module of this VR plus minus. So VR plus minus is a B module, but maximally cell to some module means that this is B module and the B action is expanded to the, extended to the corresponding cell to action. And this kernel QR is a maximal one. And by sending this VR plus minus by this linear operator, the kernel QR becomes zero, but so this is isomorphic to the quotient by this kernel QR, but this is also isomorphic to the maximally cell to some module of another B module, V minus plus P minus R. But the quantum weight is shifted by minus one, which causes such situation. And in this situation, we call such B module V plus minus R, the Feigen-Chiprin B module, for G equals L2 case. And if we have such a nice short-cut sequence, by applying this shift cohomology to this short-cut sequence, we have the following long-cut sequence of cohomologies. So first, since the kernel of QR is L2 module, this is preserved under the global selection functor. So H0 SL2 times B kernel QR is isomorphic to kernel QR itself. And this minus, because the third one is minus, because of the shift of Cartan weight by minus one, this must be zero. And H1 of the first term is also zero because this is the SL2 module, and third term is also zero because of the minus one shift. So we have the H0 SL2 times BVR is isomorphic to maximal SL2 submodule and H1 is vanishing. So under the Feigen-Chiprin setting, taking global selection functor is equal to the taking maximal SL2 submodule. And this situation is given by the following diagram. The left hand side is VR plus, and the right hand side is VP minus R minus. And this green part, so in the left hand side, 0, 2, 2, 2, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4 is the kernel of QR. And purple or pink part is the quotient of this one. And it's the same in the right hand side. And the horizontal arrows mean the B action or the action F in N minus. And up down arrows mean the so-called sequence of this P module. Namely, kernel QR is the maximal SL2 sum module, or in some sense, the maximal semi-simple module. And by taking the quotient, we have the all purple part. But this all purple part in the left-hand side, 1, 1, 3, 3, 3, 3, also appear in the right-hand side as the maximal SL2 sum module, namely kernel QR, kernel QP minus R. But the Cartan weight is shifted. In the left-hand side, for example, 1,1 corresponding to 0 minus 2, but in the right-hand side, 1,1 corresponding to 1 minus 1. So the Cartan weight is shifted. This is our fundamental situation. And as we explained above, taking global selection functor means taking a SL2 sum module from these B modules. And the same result holds for general G, at least in the case G called type ADE. Let us take the P, the same integer bigger than 2, and let us give the parameter set large lambda, given by 1 over root of P, P over root of PQ, and large P is the weight lattice, and large Q is the root lattice. And it has a representative as follows. And lambda hat is a minuscule weight, and lambda bar is the remaining part. And we can consider the while group action this parameter set as follows. And v lambda is a set of weight of v modules. And we have some linear operator for each I and lambda, satisfying the same kind of short-circuit sequence of v module. And this epsilon lambda sigma I is defined by this one, and this is minus one from the direction of alpha I. And we call such situation v lambda is a Fehling spring v module for G. Then we can prove the following. This is given in my first paper, I think. The H0 G times BV lambda is by sending the global section to the value at the original point of the flag variety. H0 G times BV lambda is embedded to the V lambda. And this is isomorphic to the maximal G submodule of this V lambda. And this is also contained in the joint kernel of these linear operators. And if lambda is sufficiently near to zero, this condition is also given. Then this inclusion is equal. Namely, if lambda is sufficiently near to zero, H0 G times BV lambda is isomorphic to the joint kernel of these linear operators. So, as in the case G equals L2, for any G, taking global section functor is taking maximal G sum module. And this is a remarkable difference from the Borel-Weibull theorem. Because Borel-Weibull theorem, we have the line bundle. So the fiber is one dimensional B module. But in the Fehling-Spring setting, the fiber is very large. So the global section, the space of global section is embedded to the fiber itself. Nevertheless, this remarkable difference, the following Fehling-Spring version of Borel-Weibull theorem holds. If lambda is sufficiently near to zero, or root of p lambda bar is contained in the fundamental curve of the corresponding affine wide group, then the nth sheaf cohomology isomorphic to the n plus L double zero sheaf cohomology. And double zero is the longest element of the wide group. And minus rho, rho is the wide vector. In particular, by taking n is bigger than zero, the right-hand side must be zero, because L double zero is equal to the dimension of the flag variety. And if we take n equal to 0 and by combining the cell duality, we obtain the following duality between H0 G times BV lambda and H0 G times BV double 0 lambda dual. And the proof is almost the same as the BWB theorem. So we use a nice short-lived sequence repeatedly for the corresponding minimal expansion of the longest element of the wild group. So we have some nice theorems on the Fehling-Spring B module. And we don't need any setting on Bartek Soppeter algebra here. And let us apply these results to the study of non-rational Bartek Soppeter algebra. And this is the original example. Maybe this is a motivation that Fehling-Spring introduced to conjectures the Fehling-Spring construction. We consider the non-rational Bartek Soppeter algebra W1P. And in the homological block side, this corresponding to the three leg star graph. So this is the easiest Prandtl graph. And by using the same notation above in the Fehling-Spring setting, let us take V0 as the lattice Bartek Soppeter algebra associated with the rescaled root lattice root of PQ. And V lambda is the corresponding simple V root of PQ modules. Because by the parameter set large lambda, the simple V root of PQ modules are classified. And under this setting, we have the short screening operator from V lambda to another V sigma I star lambda. And sigma I is the simple reflection corresponding to alpha I. And we take the following conformal vector of this V root of PQ. So this large Q0 is the, how to say, some special part of this, our setting. And the Bartek Soppeter algebra W1P is defined by the joint kernel of this short screening operator. So this is the Bartek Soppeter subalgebra of this large Bartek Soppeter algebra. And this W1P is, in the case G equals L2, called the triplet Virasoro algebra or triplet Bartek Soppeter algebra. And this is one of the most famous type of non-rational multiplicative algebra studied by many, many people. And now, almost the representation theory or its structure is almost under that. However, for the case, general G case, the algebraic so VOA structure is very complicated. So we cannot use the, how to say, direct method or computational algebraic method to such general case. So nothing was known about for a long time. So in order to study the W1P for general G case, let us use the Feigenbaum-Stieglitz construction. We can define the negative volume subgroup action on this V lambda by the following. If I is some lattice vertex operator, zero mods, and HI is minus 1 over root of P alpha I zero plus some constant. To take constant is needed because the Carlton weight must be integer. Then, by decomposing this V lambda to each direction alpha I, and using the result in the case G equals L2, we can check that this V lambda is a Feigenbaum-Stieglitz module. So we can use the general results on the Feigenbaum-Stieglitz construction to this our vertex operator algebra. So first, W1P is isomorphic to H0 G times B with BQ Feigenbaum-Stieglitz construction. Because in the case lambda, lambda is sufficient to near to zero, the Feigenbaum-Stieglitz construction is isomorphic to the joint kernel of linear operators. In particular, we can show that this H0 G times B V to PQ plus lambda for any lambda is also H0 G times B V to PQ lambda, the V to PQ module. This is also W1P module. So we can study the property of such kind of Feigenbaum-Stieglitz constructed W1P module by using geometry or Borel-Weber-Voss theorem. And this is a conjecture by Feigenbaum-Stieglitz and proved in my first and second paper. And if lambda is sufficiently near to zero, then we have the cohomology vanishing. And because the Virasoro action commutes with the Borel subgroup action, we have the character formula of this Feigenbaum-Stieglitz constructed module. So here L beta is a finite dimensional irreducible G module with the highest weight given by beta. So the character of this H0 G times B is given by the positive Carlton weight side of the fiber space. So we use this character formula later. And yes, character of Feigenbaum-Stieglitz is reduced to the half side of, or more restricted side of, character of fiber. And second, by considering the duality between H0 and H0 dual, we can show that H0 G times BV lambda is simple as W1P module. In particular, in the case lambda equals 0, or in the case P is bigger than H, bigger than or equal to the H minus 1, W1P itself is given by the Feigenbaum-Stieglitz construction, so W1P is a simple VOA. So by using this geometric and general setting, Feigenbaum-Stieglitz construction, we can study a part of representation theory of W1P without studying a vertex operator algebra structure. So this is useful. And not only the Feigenbaum-Stieglitz, W1P, but also the principal double algebra in this case is studied by Feigenbaum-Stieglitz construction. This WP minus H is a principal double algebra, universal principal double algebra with level is given by P minus H or 1 over P minus H by Feigenbaum-Stieglitz duality. Because this Feigenbaum-Stieglitz constructed H0 G times BV lambda has a natural G action, and we can decompose it as the G module times each the family of weight. So this W minus root of P alpha plus lambda is the family of corresponding weight of this G module. And W0 is the vertex operator algebra, vertex operator subalgebra of this V root of PQ. And each family of weight vectors is W0 module. And we can show the following by using a character formula or Borel-Weber-Voss theorem like this one. If P is bigger than or equal to H minus 1, H is a Carlton. Coxeta number, then this W0 is isomorphic to the universal principal double algebra, and this is also isomorphic to its simple quotient. More precisely, for any alpha and lambda substituted near to zero, we have the following isomorphisms as WP minus HG module. So, namely, the family of weight vectors is isomorphic to the Arakawa-Frenkel WP minus HG module in the paper by Arakawa-Frenkel in 2018, I think. And this is also isomorphic to the corresponding simple quotient. And in the paper, original paper by Arakawa-Frenkel, they proved the simplicity of this type of WP minus HG module for the case the level is non-rational. But in our case, the level is a positive integer. So by using Feyn-Inch Prince construction, we can study representation theory of double algebra at some difficult levels. So this is also, I think, useful for the study of double algebra Y as a type of vertex operator algebra. So as we show above, Feyn-Inch Prince construction has some desirable properties. So it is independent of the vertex operator algebra structure. So we don't have to study about complicated structure of non-rational vertex operator algebra, and but we can use some geometric results. And as this type of Feyn-Inch Prince construction is desirable as a basic step in the expected iterative algorithm to compute the homological block or construct the corresponding vertex operator algebra. So the next natural question is consider the second easiest case. So how about a four-leg star graph? So because W1P corresponding to the three-leg star graph, this is the easiest case of Prandtl graph. So we want to consider the four-leg case next. And together with the W1P three-leg case, by Chen Chan, Feigen, Gukov, Harris, Pastano, the corresponding VOA is known to be WPP dash. This is another non-rational vertex operator algebra studied by, for example, Feigen, Semikatov, Gaidon, Chipney, and Tsuchiraut, and maybe Adamovich-Milas. WPP dash is studied only for the case G equals L2. It is natural to consider the Feigen-Chipney construction for this, also to this WPP dash module. And from this, from here, I want to explain about this idea. And note that from here, the work is in progress, so this is not proved yet. So please be careful. Let us explain my idea for this problem. For simplicity, we consider the case G equals L2 from the end of this talk. The second example is the WPP dash and four-leg case. And P and P dash is integer bigger than 2, and they are coprime. And the lattice vertex operator algebra is the same, so namely the rescaled root lattice. And but the conformal vector is different. So Q0 is different from the case W1P case. And corresponding to this difference of conformal vector, we take the different parameterization of this simple module of the V to PP dash Q. So we write V plus minus RS as follows, and beta RS is the parameterization of this one. And there are also two types of short screening operators corresponding to each parameter R and S. And WPP dash is, as in the case W1P, the joint kernel of two types short screening operators on the lattice vertex operator algebra. And it is also known that the simple WPP dash modules are given by this joint image of these short screening operators. So we write it by XRS plus minus. This is, in some sense, the circle or submodule of this VRS plus minus. And we want to give the Feyn-Inch Prince construction for this XRS plus minus. And the answer is maybe this is given by nested Feyn-Inch Prince construction, and I want to explain about this idea and why this is validated. And because the conformal vector is different, the circle sequence of lattice vertex operator algebra is also different. In this case, the so-called sequence of VRS plus minus the Virasoro module is given by the following braided type structure. So in the case of Ginch-Prin or W1P, the so-called sequence is given by chain type structure. So there are only two types of irreducible Virasoro modules. But in this case, there are four types of Virasoro modules, and the so-called sequences are a little complicated than W1P case.So each triangle square and diamond and n circle n corresponding to the simple Virasoro component. And this simple WPP' module XRS plus minus is given by the circle of this Virasoro structure.So we consider the case the level is rational, so this is a corresponding Virasoro is a minimal model. So because of this result, VP minus RS minus is given by the following, because we change R by P minus S, after P minus R, so we have to exchange circle and diamond and triangle and square.So we have the following so-called sequence in this case. But to apply the Feigen-Chiprin setting naively, so we want to define the Feigen-Chiprin B plus action or B plus module structure on this lattice vertex vector algebra module that's compatible with the Virasoro structure. However, it is impossible by the following two reasons. First, there are not enough lowest orbit vectors in the Kalta negative base site. So the Feigen-Chiprin discussion is the discussions for the only one parameter. So we want to focus on the only one parameter, so R, and we want to ignore S, forget S. But in order to focus on the first parameter R, we would like to consider the pairs of this square and circle and triangle and diamond as one single weight vector. Because square and circle has the same first parameter, P minus R, and triangle and diamond also has the same first parameter R. So if we focus on this first parameter, they must be containing a single weight vector.But there are not enough weight vector in the Kalta weight negative side. So if it has the Feigen-Chiprin B module structure, for example, the circle 0 circle 1 and diamond 0 or such kind of lowest weight vector must be exist, but there are no such kind of corresponding irreducible component here.And second, there is annoying Virasoro action or arrows between different weight vectors. So Virasoro action with respect to another second parameter S. So if there exists the desired Feigen-Chiprin B module action E from the Kalton weight space of weight minus 1 to plus 1,then, since such kind of E sends this triangle 1 to 0, because in the Kalton weight of 1, there are no corresponding component. But by this commutativity of this diagram, this diamond of 2 also sent to be 0. But this is not the Feigen-Chiprin B module, because if this is the Feigen-Chiprin B module, this action of E must be surjective.And my idea is to solve these two problems to consider the staggering. Namely, we take the direct sum of these two types of lattice vertex operator algebra modules relating this the second short screening operator. As vector space, this is the direct sum, but we consider the different Virasoro structure on this direct sum. So in the right-hand module, VP minus R, VP dash minus S plus,we consider the ordinary Virasoro action, but in the left-hand side module, so the original module, we consider some different module. So lambda A is given by the following, and is given from left-hand side to left-hand side. And staggering was used by as a method of constructing the Virasoro module with some non-semi-simple L0 action. by, for example, David Ridout and Rob Sheep and Cromer and Takano. So as vector space, Vtilda looks like the following. So for each Cartan weight space, the left one, left tower is the original fork space and right one is the glued fork space.But here, the kernel of QR is, and its quotient is given by the following. So by adding this lowest, how to say, the fork spaces to each original space, so it looks like the Fey-Inch-Prince construction. And the quotient is also given by this one. And in fact, the new V-Tilda appears to solve the two problems above.So first, for the Cartan weight negative side, the additional lattice vertex of the algebra fork space is larger than the original one. So this gives the missing lowest weight vectors. But on the other hand, for the positive or non-negative Cartan weight side, the additional fork space is smaller than the original one. So it does not change the, how to say, lowest weight vectors and character formula.And let us recall that Fey-Inch-Prince character formula is, reduces the character of H0 G times B blah 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 to the character of positive side of fiber. So it also does not affect to the character formula of the Fey-Inch-Prince. And for the second problem, so there is some annoying Virasoro action from different weight vectors. In the original setting, there is some annoying action.But by considering stackering, such kind of annoying Virasoro actions or arrows is contained in the single weight vector, like this picture. So this is the point. So we can expect that this V-tilda has a Fey-Inch-Prince B plus module structure commuting with this given staggered Virasoro module structure. So it looks like the original Fey-Inch-Prince situation. And I'm trying to eat.And if this conjecture is correct, by applying Fey-Inch-Prince construction to this staggered V-tilda, we have the following module. So the kernel QR plus on another V-tilda plus RS is given by the minus one shift of this Fey-Inch-Prince construction. And by taking the quotient of this staggered glued part, we obtain not G module, but B module.Because let us recall that in the negative Cartan weight side, the additional fork space is larger than the original one. But in the positive Cartan weight side, the additional one is smaller than, how to say, original one. So the negative part is more than sieved by the positive Cartan weight part. So the iterative module structure breaks and it gives the B module.And it is known that for such B module, there is a B, for such the Virasoro module, there is a B minus module structure given by Frobenius homomorphism by Tsuchiaut. So we can apply the Fey-Inch-Prince construction again to this H0 tilde. Where is the H0 tilde? And finally, we obtain the simple WPP dash module is given by the nested Fey-Inch-Prince construction.Here, this V-tilde is a staggered lattice vertex of the algebra modulus, and this H0 tilde is some quotient of this Fey-Inch-Prince construction. And since for each step, we use the Fey-Inch-Prince construction, so we can use some geometric theorem. So in particular, we can use character formula for each global section functors. So in fact, let us compute the character of this nested Fey-Inch-Prince construction.The first global section functor corresponding to the second parameter S, and by applying the Fey-Inch-Prince character formula to this character, we can use the character of this H0G times B H0 tilde something to the character of H0 tilde something in the Cartan weight negative, as a positive Cartan weight part. And because at the positive Cartan weight part, the additional fork space is, does not change the original one because this is smaller than original one,the character shifted by minus 1, the character of H0 tilde is given by the character of H0G times B plus something. So we can use the Fey-Inch-Prince character formula again. And by computing this, it in fact coincide with the character of this simple WPP-module XRS plus. So let us give the conclusion and the main idea. So in general, we want to extract the circle of some B module V with some complicated circle sequence as our n equal to case, so our positive level case.And so complicated circle sequence means this is far from Feigen chipping setting. But we want to describe such kind of circle sequence, circle by using Feigen chipping construction because we can use geometric technique for each step. And to do so, let us fix a parameter, one parameter from this B module and consider the staggering of V with respect to other parametersAnd staggering makes the action or arrows seemingly more complicated. But from the Feigen chipping perspective, it is rather simple because the complexity of arrows and actions all can be posed to the internal structure of weight, single weight vector. And in the Feigen chipping setting, the internal structure of single weight vector is irrelevant to the discussion. So we can deal such kind of staggered B module.As a Feigen chipping B module. And by taking the Feigen chipping construction and give some sub or quotient or something, then the G module structure breaks because the additional one is larger than original one in the counter negative weight side, but positive weight side, this is not. So the G module structure breaks and it is again B module, so Feigen chipping construction can beused again. And by repeating this procedures for each parameters on this complicated B module or staggered V module, B module V, we can give the Feigen chipping construction of the circle of this V. So this is the idea. And future work is the following. Since the three-leg case corresponding to the single Feigen chipping construction and four-leg case corresponding to the two-Feigen chipping, double Feigen chipping construction. So it is expected that n plus two-leg star graph corresponding to n times nested Feigen chipping construction. And more precisely, I expect the following situation, and this is in progress. Let us consider the lattice particles of the algebra V root of P1 to PnQ, and P1 to Pn is the coprime num integers, a bigger than 2,And let us give some the parameterization of simple V root of PQ module with n parameters. And maybe there exists some filtration of this or circle sequence of this VS as follows, corresponding to the expansion of 2 power n. And we want to give the circle of this lattice particle spread algebra modulus by using Feigen chipping construction, nested Feigen chipping construction. And let us consider V tilde. This is a staggering except for the first parameter. So this is a direct sum of 2 power n minus 1 types of simple modulus. And I expect that it has the Feigen chipping B module structure with respect to the first parameter.And as in the case n equal to 2, so the WPP dash case, the weight vector itself is very complicated. This looks like hypercube of a commutative diagram with 4n minus 1 power vertices, and each vertice is corresponding to the irreducible component of this filtration. But the relation between the weight vector is very simple. There are only one direction arrows.And by taking, so we can apply the Feigen chipping construction to such situation. And by taking the global section functor and taking some quotient of that, it is again Feigen chipping B module with respect to the second parameter again. Sorry. And by applying these procedures to each parameter S1 to Sn,Feigen chipping, so we might be given the Feigen chipping construction of the circle of this VS. And in fact, if we can apply such algorithm, then the character of this nested Feigen chipping construction is given by the nested application of the character formula of Feigen chain. And finally, we obtain almost the form of homological block of n plus 2 rec star graph. Thank you.
General,
yes. I think I have to study the detail, but I think how to say. So we have some graph like this one.
Yes.
And there are two points. Who has the how to say? How to say? For each vertices v, let us give some v is given by the number of the vertices v such that vv dash is contained in the edges, and the degree of v dash is 1. Then I think for each v such that v is bigger than I think non-zero, we can the Feigen-Chiprin construction. But we have to change this G to each vertices. So in this case, I think the corresponding log VO is given by HG1, B1, and H0, G2, B2, and something, something. And this lattice vertex operator algebra is rank 2, not rank 1. And for corresponding each direction, corresponding to each global selection functor. So this is G1 times G2 module, I see. And if we can, apply the Feigen-Chiprin construction for each global selection, it also gives a homological block of such kind of rank graph. So I think the corresponding VO is nested Feigen-Chiprin construction. I think I can prove some combinatoric aspect, but I don't know how to construct explicitly such kind of B module structure or filtration. But I think I can axiomatize some combinatoric aspect of such kind of discussion. So you mean modular property reflects some three manifold?
You have mentioned that the chat can be described as a non-modular form.
Mm-hmm.
Is it true only for the three-dimensional manifolds which are described by the plumbing graphs, or is it true in general?
I don't know when the mock modular form appear in the 3D plumbed graph case. But I think, how to say, our case is a positive level case. So for example, 3-leg case W1P is a positive integral level, and 4-leg case is the positive rational level. But Sergei Gukov et al. Conjecture that maybe there is some correspondence, how to say. In some sense, if we change the Q by Q inverse, then for theta function changes to mock theta function, and there are also corresponding vertex operator algebra. So I think this is in some sense negative level Feigen-Chiprin construction, but I don't know about it. Yes. Maybe I have to consider about this problem. I don't know what.
Okay.
I don't know. But I think the difficulty of negative case is, how to say, in the positive case, the conformal weight of lattice vertex operator algebra looks like the following. So there is a reaction. But in the negative case, it looks like this one. So there is a no reaction preserving the conformal weight.
What is the y-axis and what's the
x-axis? This one.
No. So in your graph, what is y-axis?
Not exist the B conformal weight preserving B module in this.
Just the horizontal and vertical, are you plotting something?
Horizontal, this corresponding to Fock spaces. And this is lattice point. So in the Feginch pin setting, so lattice points come to some. The Heisenberg times sum going from here. But if we take the reaction, if we apply this reaction to this lattice point vector, then it must be equal to zero. Because the lowest weight vector, conformal weight of this one is higher than this. So in such situation, there are no reaction. But I don't know, but I have to check.
Current construction of work, you have to assume that the module has to be ordinary module.
Ordinary module means, I forgot the definition.
I mean, ordinary module means that the graded vector space on each conformal weight is a finite.
In the case bilateral or principal double algebra, this is ordinary, but in the case affine, this is not ordinary, because so we have to consider the parameter q and plus z. So two variables. And if we introduce this new variable, then the affine Feginch plane decomposes into the finite dimensional eigenspaces.
D4 minus 2.
I see.
And he actually can write this in terms of some modular forms. In that case,
you mean in a negative case, don't need this second problem?
You need that. But he has some explicit form for
I see. Thank you. I will check.